Welcome to Lover's Dreams page. We're here at Portillo's in Moreno Valley, California. Say hi, Tasha.
Hello.
Hello, people. We're here about to eat our food. But we just wanted to come say, hey guys, and happy Sunday.
We had an amazing Sunday. Today we had a great Sunday. We finally filled the piece to our missing puzzle, and that was us joining church and also being a part of it and want to be able to be in the midst of it. So hope you're having a great Sunday like we are. We're about to eat and then we're going to come back and let you guys know
I am hungry.
Yeah.
I'm hungry. See you later.
After today, joining, it allowed us to understand that we're on the right path to planning our journey and building our empire. And it's really going to start with us getting on the right track with God and also planning our wedding. Yes, we're getting married February 20th, 2020. So you will be along the journey with us to see how we plan our wedding. We're going to show our engagement party and what it's going to take for us to say, I do. It's easy to feel like you want to work and not have fun, but you got to have fun while working because
that
shit why get do it?
I was just about to say that shit get discouraging. That's why motherfuckers going to work every day, like every day and not doing nothing. It's not depressing, but it's depressing to me.
Sometimes it's a lifestyle though. Sometimes you feel like this is what people
I'm not working just to pay bills.
But you really have
I'm
to
working,
understand that.
I'm working to make memories. That's mm-hmm. all life is about, is memories. You mm-hmm. ain't leaving with nothing but the
memories.
Shit you
exactly. And the memories you put instilled into people's brains. You
that's
know,
it.
The love,
the
heart. The
perception of you mm-hmm. and what you've done. That's the only thing you leave
yeah.
with.
Because nobody going to sit here and feel like, oh, it's the money they gave me. That money come and go. You party it away. You save it for a vacation to create, like you said, memories. Mm-hmm. So I just think when you're going to not having fun, it can lead to depression, you know. You going to work, that's why so many people leave on stress leave and feel like they can't take it and overwhelmed because they're not having that balance.
That's why I be telling motherfuckers, if you gonna work hard, mm-hmm. you gotta play even harder.
You have to.
You gotta play even. You work hard, you gotta
play
hard.
It's not work hard or play hard. Mm-hmm. Work hard.
Don't try to make that up. Don't try to make that up. You're really bad at that. You're really bad at that.
I'm good at that.
You can't make that up. Make something up on the spot. Make a quote up on the spot right now. Go.
Of my own?
You said no. Make
up. Let's see. Say it again.
Plagiarize. I just said make someone up on your own. You said, yeah.
Okay, give it to me.
Make a quote up. Come on.
Pertaining to what? Because you know
come
I need categories.
Come on, anything.
Okay.
Anything.
Give me
life.
A topic. Life.
Life.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Come on. What the hell is this?
That's Sprite. Okay. A quote about life.
Quote about life. Give me a quote about life. You thinking real
I'm
hard.
I'm thinking because I want it to be so real and from the heart where it ain't, because you know how to riddle and rap and rhyme. So that's why I like.
A lot of R's. You know how to riddle, rap, and rhyme.
Rap and rhyme.
That's a lot of R's.
That's about life.
Double R. Rick Rose.
No, triple R.
Triple.
Yeah.
I was about to say Triple H. Rest in peace.
Triple H.
X, fool.
Oh, gotcha. Quote about life, because you know I'm such a motivator and want to give life.
How are you going to be an entrepreneur and you can't motivate the people in your words? Oh, motivate the people in your words.
You,
come on.
But this is a game.
Yeah, I'm putting
this
to a challenge.
What you're not going to do is challenge me.
That's
sorry.
What I do.
What you're not going to do is challenge me in order for me to feel like,
come on.
Oh, you know what? The thing about life and motivation is the key to success. Boom.
She really is.
So listen.
Keep going.
The thing about life, this is my best quote I'm going to give
you. Go. What, Martin?
I'm trying to see. Okay. The thing about life, live it for yourself and not for others. What? That's what it is. We get caught up in the feeling like we about to sit here and do life based off everyone else. And the expectations, what people feel, what, how are they going to look at us? Like.
What I say.
Say it.
What, no, I want you to say what I say.
Say it.
What I know,
because you don't cuss, and I don't do cussing.
So what I say?
No, I ain't saying it.
Say it.
No, baby, you the cusser. I'm
show my personality then. Say what I say.
No.
Say what
no,
I
no,
say.
No, no, no. You say it, because I'm not going to cuss.
You ain't going to cuss for me?
I ain't going to cuss for you. You cuss for me.
Nah, you going to cuss for me?
You cuss for me.
You can't seduce me with those. I'm seducing you with mine.
But we seducing each other. But pretty much you cannot sit here and live life for other people. You got to do you. You got to do what's best for you. You got to do what makes you happy. Okay. And that's one of the things that you can't do a lot of stuff with your heart, because your heart is what gets you in trouble at times too. Because you have this huge expectation of what you do, and you have an expectation of what others will do for you, and when they don't do that.
So let me stop you right there and ask you a question.
So
you telling the people not to follow their heart?
In certain situations.
Because
you gotta know
where you shouldn't follow your heart.
When you shouldn't?
Yeah.
Follow your heart is when your mind is battling the two.
You should.
If you second, yeah, when your mind is battling. If that makes sense. I know it might not sound like it makes sense.
I'm trying to make it make sense in my head, because you my woman and everything, but it's not making sense. So I'm going to go ahead and help you out.
Okay, you can help me out. That's what you're here for.
I like that.
Yeah,
like,
that's, you
that
know,
was kind of quick.
Yeah.
For you, that was kind of quick.
Wait a minute now.
Baby, you know
I'm
anywho,
quick.
Now yeah. Let me try to help you out. Let me help you
out. You be coming for me though, but I'm going to come for you too. I'm gonna be ready. Because this stuff ain't pre-script. So I'm gonna get you.
Pre-script.
Come on.
We ain't pre-scripting nothing.
We ain't pre-scripting.
Here she go. Okay. Trying to get me. You can't get me.
Go ahead, baby.
But you always follow your heart. You don't follow your heart when somebody shows you. You know what I'm saying? That side that you don't like. You can feel like you love that person and you want to be with that person.
But don't go in every time with your heart.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
So you gotta think conscious too. Be like,
right.
I know this nigga cheating on me. I ain't finna keep going to him just because I love him in my heart.
Exactly.
That's stupid.
And it's a lot of times where it doesn't even have to deal with a man and a woman being in a situation.
Yeah,
it
ain't even gotta be a relationship. Yeah.
Anybody
it could be
that
job,
you feel.
Like,
yeah, and if
job.
Your heart isn't in it,
nah,
then don't
you know
do it. You know, so I understand what you're saying, where you're saying, why wouldn't you go in a situation with your heart if it's good intention? But at the same time, what if what you're looking for isn't what you're getting back?
Exactly.
So that's why I'm saying be cautious of how you approach the situation with your heart. That's better, huh? That's the best way I can explain. But that's how I feel about it. How do you feel? What's your quote on life?
My quote on life? You already know.
You got to tell the people.
What's my quote on life, people?
Damn,
can y'all see that?
Camera. Y'all see that? Y'all see that word? I don't know if y'all can see it. But it say family.
We should have put two M's.
Two M's, yeah, we should have put two M's. But anywho.
Shake it.
That's it. I'm all about family and making memories. Family about making moves. Family about making money. Family about money and music. That's what fam stands for.
That's the best way. That's vision. That's purpose. That's just how you gotta have it. You gotta have
But what's crazy is like everybody from where I'm from, it's like they got the same
mentality, values.
Same mentality, same thinking process. Cause it's the people that want to do something. Let me put it that way.
Right.
The people that want to do something, we all got the same mentality. Try to create a platform for the people that want to do something. And that's what's crazy.
That's a good way.
We trying to all collab and get the city on. That's what it's just all about. You got to start in your community so we can, when we start in one community, take everybody this community. Not everybody.
But even if people don't want to come together, it'll show them to want to be a part of it. Yeah. And it changes. So that's what I do really like about you guys is that it's just different.
Being in California. Who is you guys?
I can't even just say the guys. I just say the ladies, you know, being from where you're from, being from Joliet, I feel like it's just a difference being out here in Cali because you don't get the full organic feel from people in Cali. I think it's everybody trying to intentionally
try to portray a certain way they is.
Right.
But that's Cali though.
Yeah, I feel like in certain parts of Cali, once you come to Cali and you have those values, then you carry that with you. But you have to have those values before and not allow different people's situations.
I came here like changing my, like I cut my dreads.
Right,
remember
right.
I cut my dreads because I wanted to be a different person. Mm-hmm. Honestly, not even just trying to say that I wanted to change. I wanted to be a different person when I came here. I wanted to be a totally different person. I wanted to change the way I looked. I wanted to change the way I talked. I wanted to change the way I just carry myself.
You feel like you have?
A little bit. It's growing. I'm growing.
But you know, it's crazy that you wanted to get here and change. And I've been here wanting the change that you was
coming here to look
and now it's time like let's do but that's what it's that's, different change.
Remember we had talked about that how people because I lived in the Midwest people that live in the Midwest go down south and I went down south like I went from Chicago Joliet to Houston 16 years stayed in Houston down in Houston came here so it's like when you go down south and you live down south you go to the west. When you live on the west, you go to the east.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? When you live on the east, you go to the west. That's how it is.
But it's good, and it just lets you know that it's okay to leap. It's okay to step out.
Oh, it is.
It really is.
Oh, is it?
I feel like it is. I would let's have never done this. That. Let's talk about it.
What you done?
You know what?
Let me light my black. It's a black and mild.
Light that black and mild. You know what? It's good to leap. I would have never leaped before in my life. I've been consistent.
What you leap for?
For love.
Tell him.
Look at my scream.
Tell him. That scream I told you earlier. When she get excited, she scream.
And I just scream.
You screaming for?
I've been getting excited. But you know what? I leap for love and I felt. Can you give me a shot? Thanks.
One shot.
You know what? I leap for love and I felt like you have to do it. And I wouldn't have done it if my mom told me that I should have done it. I just kind of felt like.
Don't put that in the camera. We ain't advertising nobody.
Right.
We ain't getting no endorsements.
Now, if y'all do want to give us some endorsements now. You know, I just had to leave for love. And within...
What kind of shots you want? You don't want this one?
No, I want a triple-double extra shot.
You tried to give me a shot the other day when I asked for a shot. You tried to give me that shot glass.
Let me see your drink.
This?
Yeah.
You ain't got nothing in that mind? Well, first.
Totally empty. What was that off of?
Totally empty.
Totally empty.
You got me.
Coming to America. I hope no kids are like sitting here watching this. We got a drink. We got some smoke.
Nigga, it's a black amount. And all this stuff is legal. I was about to say shit.
You already said it, so let's put it all together. And all this
is legal. Yeah, like we know it's yes, legal.
But stuff. I leaped for love because I felt like I was ready for love. I was ready for change. I wanted something different. And I wanted the unknown. That's kind of scary. But
you wanted the unknown.
I wanted the unknown. Someone that I did not know.
Oh, you didn't know. Okay, I got
someone
you.
That lived... Not that I went down the line. Like, I want him to be from here, here, here. It was like...
Oh, that's the next topic.
Well, we can talk about that next. But I just felt like... That's when I felt like you go with your heart. And that's why I don't want to sound like contradicting... like I'm contradicting myself because
why I had to stop you. And, right. I know what you was trying to say, but you didn't say it. So that's
no,
why
I got you. I appreciate that.
I know what you was trying to say.
But it's like when you go into saying like, you know what, it feels right. You know, I don't got to overthink it. I don't got to question it. And sometimes you need that confirmation. But I would highly encourage someone to get that confirmation from a parent. If they're still living, or if they're not, get it from someone who's close to you, your godmom, your goddad.
Somebody that really know you, though.
And who's not going to judge you.
Exactly.
You
somebody
know,
that
so.
Really know you. Because all my family really know me. You know what I said? They know me. Like, they know me. In certain situations, I can come in, you can call and be like, what Devin going to do?
Right,
and
they're
going to tell you, like, what I'm going to do. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to do it. Because that's just me.
And that's one thing with me. If you call anybody around me, like, I'm going to do this. And I don't think anyone has told me, no, I couldn't, or no, don't do it. You know, even for the ones that do like me, who don't like me, they have never told me no. And I think that's when it comes to a situation where you feel like you really want to try something that you never tried, then people are going to encourage you to do it just to see, and not, for the most part, not going to judge you if it don't work out that way.
Yeah.
So I think with us, it was more like...
You got to be a risk taker.
You have
to. If you're not a risk taker... You have to learn or start practicing. I don't even know how you're going to practice, but you got to start practicing.
You can practice by, like...
Taking risks.
Doing
like,
stuff.
Because you was like that. You ain't...
Oh, yeah. I wouldn't.
You wouldn't.
If it wasn't
cross
planned,
the bridge.
Yeah, I wouldn't.
If the sign didn't say go, you wouldn't go.
I would not. Because I just feel like...
It could be a clear path. People walking. If that sign didn't say go, you not walking.
No, I'm going to wait. But
you're not taking no risks.
I ain't taking no risks.
People could be walking down the street, typing on the phone, texting, looking down. You're going to be like...
Because I want to be able to
not me.
Allow someone to navigate. I'm. You know, that's what it is. I like to lead people.
That's crazy we said that. Remember we was in Arizona? Mm-hmm. Reminiscing right now. Remember we was in Arizona? And we was about to cross the street,
mm-hmm.
and everybody started walking, but we was the only two that we stopped,
like,
because he didn't tell us to go.
He didn't say go. We not going. We not gonna be in a situation.
Hey,
where
we not following
like,
y'all.
We gonna
we
leave.
Leaders.
We gonna wait, and next
we
time
wait.
you know, you gotta wait. But when it comes to
y'all.
Just,
they like come on.
We not going. You know, no, we got stuff to lose. What is it? We're not going. No, no, no.
Nope. Can't do it.
No, we not.
Not on duty.
Not on, but you just got to make sure you follow your heart.
Yeah,
we really had to get this topic. I'm looking a mess, but was willing to sit here and
look
say,
me.
You know what, you good?
Look at me.
What you woofing?
Woof it. Hold on. Hold on. Look at me. Looking rough. Gutter, where you at?
Yeah.
Let's do 4 more minutes. We had 16 minutes right now. We're gonna go to 20 minutes.
On 4 now.
On phonem grade, we're going to go to 20 minutes on phonem grade.
We're going to go 20 minutes. Okay, hit it. Give
but no, nah, let's talk about that topic.
Oh, was like, God.
Females, y'all need to stop doing this.
Doing what?
I want a man that got a good job. He got to have a Corolla.
He got to have a Corolla.
Nobody want nobody with, you know, it's not.
That's the first car that came to
mind. The Corolla, you know what? It's not about people wanting.
But no, I ain't
not
finished.
Wanting.
I ain't finished.
But you can't do that because we can go with the guys too.
I ain't finished.
Hey, but my voice like, but hey.
Hey.
Go ahead.
But
no. What you say?
Y'all can't be setting them standards that high now.
But
it's
why
2019.
Do you feel when we have standards like that so high? Because you know why? Women sit here and push and do what they have to do. So
yeah.
They feel like that's why. But also, they got to be able to see the man's plan and see what he wants out of life. You know?
Exactly.
So it can't be where they don't have them high standards. Because you know, everybody is raised differently.
But what, you can't work with a man? You can't build him up if he ain't
you
got it?
You can build him up
if you can't
work
see
him.
Man, if you can't
go ahead.
See the potential in a man. Every man, in my eyes, can change.
Okay.
He can change. He just got to want to change for himself.
Yes.
And females can be the push. Like you was to me to start my dream. I was always going to do it. But you pushed me to do it earlier. You pushed me. And gave me the motivation. All right, you could do
but
this
but you're
now.
A working man. That's the thing.
That's
when you
what I said.
Say a lot
that's
of times.
That's why I said
okay.
That. Once he want to change.
Then it's change.
Yeah.
But a lot of women have the standards. Actually, all women for the most part should, if you don't. Have the standard where you want the man to be this way. And you don't feel like you got to cheerlead him along the way. You don't feel like you're going to put everything you
so
have
into
him.
So what you do
him.
When you're at that age where you like. You ain't trying to mess around. You want something serious.
What you do is carry yourself a certain way. You can't do certain things to feel like you want to get attention. And you're doing certain things to just get the attention of the man. You got to be able to feel like, you know what, I'm going to walk
y'all
in this
that,
room. I'm going to own it because I'm doing it for me. I'm going to get dressed up.
Do
I'm going to network
you.
And work this room for whatever I got to do. Because
we already look.
The guys, that's the first thing y'all looking, but
we already
it's not going to take a man for me or a lot of women out here to say, oh, he's giving me this, or, oh, I'm this much higher. No, I'm already be this much higher.
Oh,
you
yeah.
just don't add to it.
Yeah.
So I think for a woman, our thing is we just got to be able to go in a place and own it and not feel like we need a validation from
a man. And
have
that man that got that same confidence, basically.
That's it. Uh-huh. And who's not afraid to see you stand out, and even for women who's not afraid to see you stand out. And if you hold down each other, it's not about you feeling like your man is flirting with the woman and your woman is flirting with the man. You guys have to have an understanding of knowing
it's okay to be jealous. It's not
just a tiny
outright jealous, you know. I'm like, hey,
right,
I'm talking
talk
to my girl.
Yeah, but when
like,
it's
okay
point,
to be like,
we got compliments like as bad as we feel like we
look right now
like
we
got
to the
some
movies yesterday
and got compliments and
it was like y'all look good,
you're a good looking couple,
like
and,
who
and
us
we're looking like who up.
Oh, thank
but
you.
it when it comes down to it, it's how you carry yourself. It comes with the confidence of a woman that she already has for herself and a confidence of a man that he has. So when you come together, you're a force together, you know. So that's
I'm
why
forced to be reckoned with your ass.
You are. But when you come together and you know, but it's like people see that. People see the strength.
Sound like a
people do, you know, they see that.
No,
but
I need an endorsement.
Hold on, you got this one. I thought we in one endorsing. All in the camera. They know what it is. We need to get footage where it blur it out. But you know, we're just looking forward to what's to come for us. And we both have great, major, big dreams that we will definitely want you guys to see. We learned
and support.
That.
I don't just want you to see my dream. I want you to support.
That's true. And I'm sorry, that's true. That's true. And within that, we support as well. We're not asking for support, and we don't support you have an event we come into.
Yeah, if
whatever.
You go look at any of my social media, I don't post nothing.
Shares.
I share everything.
And that's
and
where
I ain't
it
sharing
comes from.
Nothing. No fights, no violent, no funny memes. I ain't sharing. Look at my page. I'm speaking the truth. I'm sharing everybody's business, everybody's careers. They wanted what they want to do. If you rap, if you sing, if you
amazing.
Make movies.
Right.
I don't care what you do. I'm sharing.
And that same thing with me. You go on my stuff and I'm pushing CPAs, I'm pushing business, I'm pushing resources to help you get to the next levels. And that's something that we do individually that we don't even be knowing until we look at each other's stories, you know? So in this life, you need a push, you need a drive. And that's what I love about Atlanta. All the ladies support each other, you know? And it's not like they're just doing it based off what we
just
see
Atlanta,
on TV.
Just Atlanta, period. Not even the ladies. Even
everybody.
About, I was just about to say, if you think about the music culture, like, Atlanta mess with Atlanta, like.
Yes.
And that's how all the cities should
be. If everybody was like that, that would be amazing.
It wouldn't be as much as the drama we got going on in this world today. It
no, if everybody stuck together, promote. It's enough money to go around. And it's so sad that people cannot push.
They burning money out here.
Right. And it's like,
it's so much money, they burning money.
For your fellow,
I don't even know why, because I ain't even in debt.
Right, it's shut down. Wait for it to open up. But
like,
we're
in debt right now. Yeah. We burning money.
Burning money.
Don't even sound
to
right.
Make the money go around. Mm-hmm. The world go around. But it's just like, that's what I love about the support and being able to say, you know what, you can't do, and it's probably saying this because people always say it and always say it, but you can't sit here and feel like you wait to the person to get hot in your eyes before you feel like you're ready to support. You got to support when you first see something coming up. You got to feed into
it. If you wasn't with me shooting in the gym, you ain't coming to the championship game.
You can't even come to the game unless you're going to be all the way in the back. But you can't sit here and be someone's starting team if you have not supported them, if you haven't even fed into them. And support is not always putting money up. Support could be sharing something. Support could be encouraging the person, like something. Like, give people
something.
There's
two buttons you got to press to support.
What is it?
Share and share.
That's it. That's it.
You gotta press it twice.
You ain't even gotta comment.
You ain't gotta comment.
Just share it.
You can press share twice. You press it one time, and it confirm you wanna share, write a note. No, you don't write a note. Press share again.
That's support. And I just wish, and I will encourage, and it's not even to
say
here.
Some of my followers ain't your followers.
Right. And you gonna reach people. And I just highly encourage, it don't even have to be our business, but I highly encourage anyone, if you know somebody who have a business, if you just come across somebody that you vibe with, it'll become your turn. Wait your turn and it will happen. You can't sit here and feel like, I'm not going to support this person because I got my own thing going on. No, you can definitely do what you need to do.
He ain't support me. He ain't like my
And I was like that. I was catty like that. I was so catty like that. Like, they can do this. I ain't going to do it.
But stop, you know, worrying what? About other people.
You cannot
people.
Worry about other people because
I used to have to drill this in their life.
Yeah, because it's true. You have to sit here and you got to be able to be in your own lane because you know what? It's so many people. It's not everybody that are you.
I do not care what. Mm-hmm. No offense. I don't care what y'all think about me.
No, it's true. You know, like, it ain't even about being sorry. It's not being about
none of that.
Any of that. It's about being able to say, you know, you got one person that's going to judge you. And that's God. That's God.
Do it. That just man in a upper room.
That's it. You got one person that's going to judge you. And that's why you feel like you cannot live your life or step out based off what other people going to say. Are they going to push? Are they
I won't
encourage?
Do nothing to make myself, you know, what they get clout. I won't do nothing.
No, you ain't got
to
get clout.
AKA recognition for the people that don't know what clout is.
Yeah, it took me a while to understand. Right, what's clout? But
recognition. I'm not doing nothing stupid to get no recognition, to get me out there, to get me.
Yeah, I can't do it.
I can't do it.
I tried.
I got
to show
my
a
morals. I was taught. You know,
oh, I was taught.
My mom. I was
she
taught
drilled
better
that
than
and
that.
Instilled that in us.
I got my ass whooped every time I went to the store and touched something. I ain't touching nothing else. I don't even touch nothing when I go to the store with you.
You just gotta look.
If I don't want it, I ain't touching it. If I can't get it, I ain't touching it.
No, because you know, it's just things that are set up just to get you to just fall off, to get you to a point where you just feel like.
I was watching a documentary. Sorry to cut you off.
Go ahead, no worries.
Get you to a point where what? Finish it.
So no, you're good.
Anywho.
Because you know, I'll be forgetting in a second. So, why you talking about what? Who? I don't go ahead. I forgot. I don't remember.
But I was watching a documentary And the one I showed you yesterday about the Jamaica dude. Mm-hmm. Jamaica dude said,
about people paying, living to pay bills and need to be in places where you feel like the pressure of life isn't.
What he said the system set you up to live your life the way they want live you to. Their right. life.
Paying bills. And minimize those bills. Like,
just think it's about okay. it. The third world countries, or you they know have what I'm peace saying?
Sometimes. Like, you know, to us, the fact that
they like to peace. Us, they struggling. You know what I'm saying? And the outside them. Looking in, they struggling because they see how we living. Mm-hmm. But this not even supposed to be how we living. You feel me? It's like,
no, I got what you're saying. We looking at them like when we on vacations in Bahamas, Jamaica, and we're going there to have peace, tranquility. They looking at us like, oh my gosh, they're doing this, they're doing this, they're doing this. Like, it's the life. It's like we're looking at each other's lives right. like this other is what one they got want.
Good. Like, yeah, we want to be where they at, and they want to be where we at.
It's true. It's true.
We get money and we go to, we go to these certain places and we go look at them. We go have a good time in the nice areas. But sometimes, like what me and my friends do, mm-hmm. when we go on a cruise, we don't even take the tours. We go walking and we go in with the city. Locals. We go in with the locals. We going to see everything that's the locals see. We don't want to see what the tourists see.
No, because like I told you, when we were on vacation, that I just felt like everything looked the same to me after a while. It seemed like we'll go to one port, and then by the time at night, they'll turn the boat around and go to another.
The Southern Caribbean cruise, where it's like St. Kitts, St. Martin. And it just seemed like it was
crazy. Everything looked the same. And I'm
like, Barbados.
What, St. Lucia's?
St. Lucia's.
It's like, everything started to look the same. Puerto and it's Rico. Like you're not communicating with same. Anyone. So by you not communicating with anyone, you know, it's like, of course you're going to see the beautiful stuff and the pretty stuff. But it's just like, I want to hear stories. I want to be able to see how they live on a daily.
Exactly.
And they know everything we pretty much know. They like they got YouTube. They have Facebook, Instagram. They have everything that we have. But at the same time, to sit down and talk to them and see what their everyday life is, that's what it comes down to.
I said we're going to do 4 more minutes. We didn't do 10 more minutes.
Okay. Well, we about to close it out. Let's do a toast to 2019. Making moves with our family. And starting our friends.
Our empire. Y'all see that?
Cheers.
Cookie. That's the new cookie in Lucy's.
It's our empire.
It's our empire.
I need a chaser. What is it? Salute.
Go here. Week. I had to put that in there before I stopped the video. Peace.